AWS is renaming the AWS Certified SysOps Administrator Associate certification to the AWS CloudOps Engineer Associate. And in this video, I'm going to let you know everything that you need to know if you are planning to certify or recertify for this certification. Now, over on the AWS website here, we can see that the new exam is going to be available from September 30th, 2025. So if you're watching this video after that date, then it's ready and you can register and you can take the CloudOps Engineer Associate. Now, as I mentioned, this is a new version. It's a rename of the SysOps Administrator Associate. And that's important to know because essentially the content is very, very similar. There's just some slight changes. In fact, the code for this exam is just a new number version compared to the old exam, but they've decided to give it a bit of a rebrand, a new name. Most of the content is the same. There's a few additional services, and I'm going to go into all of the details of that so that you know what you need to know to be prepared for taking the exam. So let's go through some of those details. Now, as I mentioned, the exam code, it used to be the SOA C02 when it was the SysOps Administrator Associate, and now it's going to be the SOA C03. So essentially, it's just a new version of the exam. The level is Associate, of course, and it's 130 minutes long, so 2 hours, 10 minutes. No changes there. 65 questions, no changes there. $150, that's the normal price for an associate level certification. You can take it in a testing center or you can take it online, which is what I always prefer to do these days. From a scoring perspective, again, it's the same as the other associates with a passing score of 720 points out of a potential 1,000. Now, if we just compare old versus new, because I just want to give you an idea of the differences here, and you'll note these are the domains. So these are the different, AWS breaks down the exam into different content domains. So essentially the sort of knowledge areas, the things you need to know, the topics, the subjects, the services that you need to understand for the exam, basically. And so here you can see the old versus the new. Now, if you study this a little, you'll notice it's almost identical. Really, the difference is they collapsed from six domains with the SysOps Administrator, C02, to five domains. Now, one of those areas has just been moved. So you can see cost and performance optimization. Well, performance optimization is now in domain one. So they just kind of reallocated that into a different place. So they just changed the breakdown of how they organize the content. Cost seems to have been removed, so the word isn't included in the domains anymore. But there's still mention of it in the exam guide. So I don't think it's been, it may be de-emphasized, but it's certainly still there. Now, what does this really mean to you? Really, I'm just telling you this because you need to understand, you know, what the differences are. If you were already studying, for example, for the SysOps Administrator or you're recertifying, then you might be concerned that there's a big change. It's almost the same. Like, this really is meaningless to you in terms of it's really just how AWS organizes the content. At the end of the day, they've reorganized things and they've slightly changed the percentages, the weightings that make up the content in the exam. But as long as you're prepared and you know all these topics, really doesn't matter how they organize it. Now, what is different is there are around 25 new services added that were not included in the SysOps Administrator Associate. So that's kind of normal for AWS. When they release a new version of an exam, they often do that. They'll add in services and they don't really remove them. So according to AWS, they haven't removed any of the services from the previous to the new version. So it's like you just, they're expanding the content, expanding the services that you need to learn. AWS is a growing platform. And so, of course, there are many new services released every year, and some of them are becoming more and more important for businesses. So it's important to upskill and you've got to make sure that you study the exam guide and know what is new. The exam now officially covers containers, so ECS, EKS, ECR. Now, I say officially because it was an out-of-scope service in the previous exam guide, and yet it appeared in the exam. And so I would cover it in my practice exams, and students would often ask me, why are you covering this? It's not in the exam guide, but it was there in the exam. So now it's actually officially part of the exam guide. There are some additional database and analytics services and operational insight services like Grafana and Prometheus as a couple of examples that have been added into the exam guide. There's quite a few new networking services and features and some of the tracing and reachability tools that have been added in as well. Now, I always recommend checking the exam guide. So you can find the exam guide on the AWS website. This does tell you all of the details you need about what you're expected to know. Content types, we'll talk about that more in a moment. The exam domains, of course, and then the individual skills. But if we scroll right down, what you will also find is a list of in-scope services and features. So whatever training you're using, because some of the training, mine is being fully updated for the CloudOps Engineer Associate exam. Some training might not be updated. So just make sure you come into here and you study this list and you make sure that if it's not covered in your training plan, then you add that in. Maybe just go up to the AWS documentation, learn about this service, practice if you can. So definitely worth checking the exam guide. Now, in terms of the exam format, the question format is multiple choice and multiple response. The good thing is that means that the old exam lab format has not been brought back because that was actually retired. In fact, if we go to the exam guide for the SysOps administrator, the older exam, you can actually see that here. So as of March 28, 2023, the exam labs were removed. So they weren't very popular. People didn't really like them. So I think that made this exam a lot less popular. And so AWS reacted to that and they removed the exam lab requirement. So you didn't actually have to go in and do a hands-on test as part of your exam. So it is back to purely just answering questions. Important to note that every AWS exam has some unscored questions. So in this exam, there are 15 questions that are unscored. They are there because AWS is adding in new questions and seeing how well people do with those questions and trying to work out if they're the right level of difficulty. You know, they got their analytics going on that. So it's important to note because that means that there's 15 questions in the exam that don't affect your score. So only 50 of the 65 questions affect your score. What I've noticed also is that sometimes some of these questions, I think it's these questions anyway, these unscored questions, because I come into the exam and I notice that they seem to be just a lot harder. I get a few questions that are really hard and I'm quite familiar with the exams. I've taken them all lots of times. So I kind of understand what the level of difficulty should be. And so it's important to note because sometimes that can throw you off a little bit. So if you do see some questions that seem exceedingly hard and sometimes even the topic areas seem to be out of alignment with the exam guide, don't worry too much. They might be in there for analytics purposes. They might be sort of testing out some new questions. So just don't get stressed about it. Try to carry on, give it your best shot, and then move on to your next question. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope that was useful for you. Main thing is just don't worry about the changes. We've updated our training, and really it's just a few new services that you need to learn. Outside of that, all of the content is the same as the older version of the exam. Is really, it's just a rebrand, a new name of the old exam with some new services thrown in. If you found this video useful, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video so you can see more like this.